I don't see anybody else. Let's see. Oh, there. Hello.
Hello. Hello, ladies. I'm just going to turn my phone off. Manishma, nice to see you all again.
Same here.
Yeah, I'm here. Hope you had a nice Purim.
Yep.
Yes, we. Tov, okay, so we're on to our next parasha. Parashat Ki Tisa. It's unbelievable how weeks just fly by so fast. It just feels like it's happening too fast.
Funny how that seems to go the older you get.
The faster it goes.
Definitely.
So here we are, Parashat Ki Tisa. It seems like just a minute ago we were down to Egypt with Yosef, and here we are already in Chet HaEgel. This parasha, it holds the descriptions of Klei HaMishkan, and afterwards we have Chet HaEgel, and then we have Moshe's praying and pleading for Am Yisrael after Chet HaEgel. And that's where Rav Dessler actually comes in. And first I'm going to say what the psukim are going to say, and then we'll read it together in the psukim. So after Chet HaEgel, Moshe mentions again what happened at the Sneha Bo'er. Okay, he says, you met me outside on Har Chorev at the Sneha Bo'er. You told me, Ta'aleh ta'am hazeh mimitzrayim, take my nation out of Egypt, but you didn't really give me any directions. You didn't tell me how to do it, when to do it. You didn't tell me what. You just told me do it. And echshu etzlachti letamren. I was able to maneuver and bring them here out to the desert. Somehow we were able to do it. But you really didn't give me specific, I don't know if directions is the word. In Hebrew, we would say hora'ot.
Instructions,
thank you. You didn't really give me instructions how to do it. So Moshe says to him now, after Chet HaEgel, after HaKadosh Baruch Hu kvar chiper le'am Yisrael, אחרי שהוא סלח להם, he says to him, הודעני נא כבודך, I want you to explain to me, please, exactly in a very, איך אומרים, מבחינה מקצועית,
professional.
In a professional way, how do you want me to continue to lead, to be a leader for this nation? And then HaKadosh Baruch Hu will say, okay, from now on it will be me, ani velo malach, soon we'll read it. And then Moshe asks for he has another bakasha, another request, and he says, Har'eni na kvodecha. There are two different quests in Moshe. The first one is, Hodi'eni na darkecha. Hodi'eni, hodi'a is explain to me, okay? Explain to me how you want me to do things. And then the second quest, the request that he has is, please, I want to understand why. Not how to do things, but why. I want to know how you rule your world, okay? השאלה של הלמה, למה ככה העולם מתנהל? למה זה ההנהגה שלך בעולם? Okay, Moshe actually wants to see the inner part of Kadosh Baruch Hu ruling the world. Okay, and then Kadosh Baruch Hu says to Moshe, he says, "You can't see me, but you can see Panai lo tirau ela atachorai." Soon we'll read it in the psukim, and he says to him, "Look, I'm going to put you in a little cleft inside the sela. You'll sit there, and I will pass over you, and only once I'm passed over you, you'll be able to see the behind of me, okay, את האחוריי. כלומר, in our words, הקדוש ברוך הוא tells him, I can't explain to you exactly where I am and what I am and what I'm doing, but any place that you'll be looking for me, you'll be able to find me, like little footprints in the snow. I'm going to leave footprints behind me. Reminds me a little bit of what Chazal or the Kabbalah say, that a lot of times we can't see something, but we can feel it. Like the wind, you can't see the wind, but you can see the branches swaying back and forth in the wind. Or if someone put on perfume and left the house and you walk in, you can't see the person, but you can feel, you can smell the perfume that she wore. Chazal call it Rishimo. Rishimo is like this, is like the sign, not the sign, but what stands on the man's hand after he takes off his tefillin. When you put on tefillin, you're supposed to pull the strings tight enough, the tefillin tight enough, in order that when you take off the tefillin, you'll have their Rishimo. Okay. So I want to say, first I'll say it in Hebrew, שבשבילי זה קטע מאוד מרגש. These psukim are very meaningful and very moving, because this is הנהגת השם בעולם. We can't understand, we can't see, but we can only see what he leaves behind, for the good and for the bad. בעזרת השם, we should have many good רשימות in our life, our health and our happiness and our children and our family and our friends and our yeshuv and our house and anything good that happens to us in our life is the Rishimo of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that he left it there for us. ולא עלינו, לפעמים גם יש רשימו של דברים יותר קשים. אז זה משהו מאוד, מאוד מרגש בשבילי. Okay, so let's read it in the Psukim. And then we'll see where Arav Dessler focuses on one word, and this is our shiur today, on one word, basically. Okay, so let's read the Psukim. So this is after, אחרי שהקדוש ברוך הוא סלח למשה ולעם ישראל על חטא העגל, אוקיי? ויאמר משה אל אדוני, ראה אתה אומר אליי, העל את העם הזה, ואתה לא הודעתני את אשר תשלח עמי, אוקיי? He's reminding him what, he's mentioning again the מעמד וסנה הבוער, אתה אמרת אליי, העל את העם הזה, you told me, bring up my nation from Egypt, ואתה לא דעתני את אשר תשלח, but you didn't explain to me how to do it. ואתה אמרת ידעתיך בשם, וגם מצאת חן בעיניי. ואתה אמנה מצאתי חן בעיניך, הודעני נא דרכך, ודעיך. למה נמצא חן בעיניך? Please explain to me how do you want me to do things. Okay, so I will know you, what you want from me, what you expect from me. למה נמצא חן בעיניך, so you like what I'll do. וראה כמך הגוי הזה, ויאמר, and now השם answer is, פנה ילכו ואניחותי לך. הקדוש ברוך הוא accepts it, and he's willing to give him a very good answer, and Rashi explains to us, from now on, it will be with not a מלאך, not a שליח, but me. And then Moshe, after a few פסוקים, goes on, and he says, ויאמר אדוני אל משה, גם את הדבר הזה אשר דיברתי אעשה, כי מצאת חן בעיניי, ודעך בשם, and then Moshe asks for another בקשה, another request, ויאמר, הראני נית כבודך, show me who you are, explain to me, why do you do things the way you do, why do you rule the world like this? And then הקדוש ברוך הוא answers him, ויאמר, אני אעביר כל טובי על פניך, I like that he used the word כל טובי, אני אעביר כל טובי, you're going to see all the good that passes right over you, וקראתי בשם אדוני לפניך, וחנותי את אשר אחון, וריחמתי את אשר ארחם. You won't be able to know or to understand why I am merciful for certain people and other people it's midat hadin. You'll only be able to see what's left behind. The people that were midat hadin, ומי שזכה וקיבל את מידת החסד. ויאמר, לא תוכל לראות את פניי, כי לא יראני האדם וחי. A live person cannot see, cannot understand HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the way he rules the world, why he rules the world. You can't understand it while you're still connected to the big obstacle of your body. למכשלה הזאת של הגוף. הגוף לא מאפשר לנו להבין את זה. Okay. ויאמר אדוני, הנה מקום איתי, וניצבת על הצור. Here, there's a place over here right next to me on the rock. And Chazal explained that there was a little... cleft inside the tzur in the rock, and that's where Moshe was sitting. והיה בעבור כבודי ושמתיך בנקרת הצור, sorry, this is where he explains it, וסקותי כפי עליך עד עוברי, ואסירותי את כפי, וראית את אחוריי ופניי לא יראו. Okay, You can only see once I was here, but you can't see the front. You can't see the explanations. So, okay. So we understood the background of this pasuk because Rav Nevinzal is zooming in on the pasuk. Vayomer Adonai, hine makom iti, v'nitzavta al atzur. And Rav Dessler tries to understand what does it mean, hine makom iti. Okay, what is the definition? What does the word makom mean? Okay, so let's read in Rav Dessler's words. Okay, Rav Dessler, maybe I'll just first say that the first number two that we're going to read, the first words of Rav Dessler are actually Rabbi Nachman. He brings something very nice from Rabbi Nachman, and this drash of Rabbi Nachman is based on the Rashi for this pasuk, for pasuk pasuk of Aleph. Okay, hine makom iti. So let's read it and explain it. Kshayesh lehadam lev, en shayach etzlo makom klal, ki ad rabba hu mekomo shel olam, ki ha'elokut hu balev, kmo shekatuv, tzur levavi. Let me stop here for a second and explain. Rabbi Nachman, based on Rashi, he says like this: when a person has a heart, a human being has a heart, it's irrelevant to think about the place of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because we all know that what is the right place for HaKadosh Baruch Hu to be? Ma atem omrot? Efa hamakom shebo nimtza HaKadosh Baruch Hu?
Ushechanti betocham.
ושכנתי בתוכם, ועשו לי מקדש, ושכנתי בתוכם. בדיוק למדנו את זה לפני כמה שבועות. אז כשבן אדם יש לו לב, המילה מקום, שעוד מעט נבין את המשמעות שלה, היא לא רלוונטית. כי איפה הקדוש ברוך הוא צריך להיות? בתוך הלב. זה מה שאומר לנו רבי נחמן. When a person is serving Hashem, when a person is working on his midot, on building the mishkan in his heart, it's irrelevant to ask, where is Hashem? It is irrelevant to complain, soon we'll see, about things in life, in the place where Hashem brought me to. Okay? Let's continue reading Rabbi Nachman over here. ואצל השם יתברך נאמר, הנה מקום איתי. What does the word מקום mean? הוא מקומו של עולם, ואין העולם מקומו. First, we'll explain Rabbi Nachman what he's saying here, and then we'll continue. What does it mean shehu mekomo shel olam ve'en ha'olam mekomo? If we ask where is the Kadosh Baruch Hu in our world, what would we answer?
Everywhere.
Any place you look for him, that's where you find him, right? A lot of times Chazal expect us to make the mistake of thinking that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is only in the Torah, is only in the mitzvot, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is only bebet HaMikdash or bakotel, only in these holy places. And Rabbi Nachman, and maybe we should say Rav Dessler via Rabbi Nachman, says it's not shayach to ask what is the place of God, because any place where you look for him, that's where he is. Okay? Hu mekomo shel olam. Okay? HaKadosh Baruch Hu fills the whole world. He doesn't have a specific place. Okay? בוא נמשיך לקרוא את זה עוד קצת. שהוא מקומו של עולם, ואין העולם מקומו. נמצא, מי שיש לו לב ישראלי, the Jewish person or a person that is connected to God, that serves God, אין ראוי לו לומר שמקום זה אין טוב לפניו. It's not ראוי, it's pasnished, it's not מתאים to say, for a person to say, I don't like where I am, I don't like this job, I don't know my wife is like this, why my husband is like that, why are my children doing like that. אין ראוי לומר שמקום זה אין טוב לפניו, כי אין שייך אצלו מקום כלל. כי עד רבה הוא מקומו של עולם, ואין העולם מקומו. Okay, this is what Rabbi Nachman says. Every person should know that any place where he finds himself during his lifetime, any single place where you are, A place is not only physical, of course, it's situation, it's a state, it's a marriage, it's a family, it's a job, it's anything that you have. Everything is a Kadosh Baruch Hu. A Kadosh Baruch Hu brought you to this place. And that's why you shouldn't be asking, why am I in this place? Why am I not in that place? I'm not happy over here. I would be happier in a different marriage. I would be happier in a different yeshuv, in a different home, v'chule v'chule. Okay, so this is where Arab Dessel starts off. Okay, and let's continue to number three.
But it's so natural to think that way.
What?
It's so natural to think that way. I don't like where I am right now, or I don't like what I did. And then you try to change, you know, maybe you'll change it. So that's a very natural way of thinking. I think that's innate. And what he's trying to change, you know, what I am, it's very hard.
First of all, it's very beautiful what you're saying and very mamash amiti. It's very real to say, oof, I don't like this. I don't like my life. I don't like my life right now. It's very natural to say that. But when we say that, we are connected to the, soon we'll see that he's going to talk about it. We're connected to Yetzer Hara, to Sitra Achra. Because the highest spiritual level is to tell myself, to say to myself that, okay, I don't like what's happening to me in my life right now. I'm not happy with it. But I understand that this is where God wanted me to be right now. But I understand that this is what Hashem is asking me right now, to be in this place and to serve him from this place.
If you take out the words, I'm not happy, I can't see that as being something negative. In other words, not I'm not happy, but I would like to be able to hitkadem hala. I think that's the whole idea of mankind. You don't want to stay in a status quo. You want to be able to hitkadem.
נכון, אבל עוד מעט נראה למה הוא אומר את זה ככה. אבל אני רוצה להתייחס למה שאתי אומרת ספציפית, because it's very natural to say, I'm not happy. I don't like my life right now. And you can't immediately jump to the next step and say, okay, let's change things. יאללה, הכל לטובה, הכל בסדר. אני רוצה לחזק את מה שאתי אומרת ולהגיד שיש חשיבות מאוד גדולה להבין, ומותר גם להגיד את זה, אני לא מרוצה, אני לא אוהבת את מה שקורה פה. I don't like what's happening right now, because only from the place when you are willing to admit to yourself, to whoever you're not happy with, when you're able to admit it, רק משמה יכול לבוא התיקון. אתם מבינות מה אני אומר? Do you understand what I'm saying? Only when you're willing to admit that that you're not happy or satisfied or you don't feel good in the place where you are, only when you're uncomfortable, then will you start moving forward. נכון?
You just said the opposite.
נכון, רגע, שנייה. רבי נחמן אומר, אוקיי? רבי נחמן אומר, אף פעם אל תגיד אני לא שמח איפה שאני נמצא. למה? הקדוש ברוך הוא רוצה אותך פה, תהיה שמח. זה מה שרבי נחמן אומר. עכשיו, אתי אומרת, רגע, זה לא טבעי, בוא נהיה אמיתיים. It's not natural to say, יאללה, סבבה, אוקיי. נכון? בואו, we're people, we're human beings. So no, first נכון, אבל אתה לא תשנה את המקום שלך אם אתה לא תבין שמשהו לא בסדר במקום שלך. נכון. למה שאני אקום ואני אצא?
אוקיי,
אני פשוט חושבת שרבי נחמן דילג פה על כמה מדרגות, ולכן אני מתעכבת ואני מסבירה את מה שאתי אומרת, כי זה ממש נכון. גם במקום של טיפול וייעוץ ואימון, בן אדם לא ישנה את החיים שלו אם הוא מרגיש בטוב ובנחת שמה. אתה חייב להרגיש לא בטוב כדי להתקדם. Okay? I'm going to just say what I said in short in English, that a person is not going to make any changes in his life if he's very comfortable and everything is good for him. You remember I brought you the paper a few, I don't know, it was maybe like already 2 months ago, Ma'agal HaNochut, the comfort zone. A person doesn't leave his comfort zone if he's comfort, unless he has a very good reason. There's something very big out there that he wants. But this is natural for a person. Okay, so the first stage that Rabbi Nachman didn't write about it in this Torah is that you're not going to move until you feel that you're in a not good place. וזה התפקיד של יצר הרע או של הסיטרה אחרא להגיד לנו לא טוב לנו פה. וזה מדרגה, it's a very high spiritual level to say, okay, I know that that it's not good for me here, but this is what Hashem wanted for me, and this is en Hashem mekomo en makom lakadosh baruch hu el Hashem hu mekomo shel olam. This is the beginning. We're just at the beginning of the idea over here. So let's continue ונראה לאיפה נגיע. Okay? So now let's look where Rav Dessler is going to take us. He's taking us on a beautiful trip. Okay, so number three. הרב דסלר ממשיך. העניין הוא שהשם יתברך קדוש ונבדל ואינו מושפע מעולמו כלל. הקדוש ברוך הוא is different, he's separated, he's different from the world, okay? The world doesn't determine where is Hashem and what kind of Hashem is Hashem. Okay? הקדוש ברוך הוא קדוש ונבדל. He is not affected by the world. Okay? העולם לא קובע אותו. The world doesn't determine who הקדוש ברוך הוא is. ובצלם אלוקים עשה את האדם. Why does הרב דסלר tell us ובצלם אלוקים עשה את האדם? I'll say it first in Hebrew and then in English. כי גם לאדם יש יכולת כזאת לא להיות מושפע מהעולם כלל, כי הוא נברא בצלם אלוקים. Rav Dessler tells us that because the mankind, the person, was created by HaKadosh Baruch Hu, B'Tzelem Elokim Asai Ta Adam, the person also has the ability not to be affected by the world at all. Okay? And I want to ask you, what does it mean to be affected by the world? What does it mean שהעולם קובע? מה אתם חושבות? What does it mean that a person is not affected by the world?
I guess if you live in a society that doesn't believe in a God or doesn't believe in the way we believe in a God, the society as a whole, that's what they do. But you as an individual, you don't have to go that way.
Okay, that's a great start, June.
Yeah.
That's Abraham Avinu.
נכון, but let's talk about ourselves. Let's talk about ourselves today. June brought the aspect of believing in God or following beliefs וכולי. אבל הרב דסלר רוצה להגיד שזה משהו הרבה יותר יומיומי שלנו. מה זה אומר לא להיות מושפע מהחוץ? What does it mean not to be affected by what's going on outside?
Think for yourself.
נכון. For your personality, for decisions, for beliefs, for anything that you do, measuring yourself ביחס למה שקורה בחוץ, measuring yourself against something that's going outside of you. He's talking about everything that's outside of the inner person. Each and one of you has her neshama and has her own olam pnimi, her own inner world, okay? And everything that's going outside of you, okay, of your inner world, is anything that's external, that is the outside world, okay? When I asked my daughter told me that they went to their friends and they were drinking their arak. I don't know how you say arak in English.
Arak.
Arak, okay, so they were drinking arak. And she told me, and I also drank. So I told her, why did you drink arak? And she said to me two sentences. She said, and then she said, וגם אני רציתי לטעום. So I said, אם כל הבנות שתו, ולכן את שתית, אז את לא מבינה איך צריך להתנהל פה בעולם. If you drank only because the other girls were drinking, So then you're not mastering yourself. You're not ruling yourself. You don't understand how it's supposed to be working in the world. Okay? But if you tell me that you drank because you wanted to taste it and to feel it, fine. I mean, I don't like it. אבל בסדר, if you want to taste it, that's fine with me. And this is exactly this is exactly what Rav Dessler is aiming for. He calls it Adam Apnim ve'Adam Achutz, a person that is that makes his decisions, that feels his feelings, that everything, anything that he says, thinks, does, okay, or feels, it's according to his inner world. It's according to the way he interprets it and feels it. Ze ben adam shel apnim. Ve'ben adam shel achutz is something that every is a person that anything that he thinks, talks, eats, feels, and does is according to what people are doing outside.
And that has to be molded very early in childhood to be able to stand up to peer pressure.
It's not only peer pressure, it's, I think it's much wider than that. It's much wider. It's you remember that we spoke about Yesod HaMaim in the personality? I don't remember when we spoke about it, but I'll just mention it again, that every person has four, זה בעצם הארבע יסודות, four bases. From the we learned this from the Kabbalah, okay? Maim, water, ruach, or avir, okay? The air, or wind, adama, earth, and fire, okay? It reminds me a little bit of Avatar, for whoever's familiar with the children's program. what does it mean a person, I'm just going to focus on water right now, al yesod ha-mayim, what does it mean a person that has a lot of water? So, yesod shel ha-mayim ze yesod meod chiyuvi. Kol ha-yesodot hem meod chiyuvim. All the yesodot, the foundations, you would say maybe, are very positive and also very negative. The positive of water is a person that is very happy and jolly and a giving person, and all the characteristics of water that you can think of are characteristics of the person. Okay, today we use a lot the word zorem, flowing. Okay, a flowing person, it has a lot of good, but the downside of the water is that it gets its value according to the outside world. If you put it in a cup, so then you can drink the water, okay? If you put it in little ice cubes, in a tray of ice cubes, then that's the way it's gonna be. It's gonna be little square ice cubes. If you put it in a pot on the fire, then it's gonna evaporate. The water depends on al achutz, amayim tluim ba'olam achitzon, eze tzuraim notnim lo. Okay, the external world of the water gives the water their tzura, their shape. Okay? Ze barur ma shehesbarti? Okay. Tov. So let's continue with Rav Dessler. So I'm going to read it again. Number 3. Ha'inyan hu she'Hashem yitbarach kadosh ve'nivdal ve'eno mushpa me'olamo klal. ובצלם אלוקים עשה איתה אדם. So a person has an option. He could be in this place of being an internal person or inwards person. שמי שהוא פנימי, what does it mean, בן אדם שהוא פנימי? It's what we spoke about before, that all the decisions and thoughts and feelings and actions that he does comes from listening to his neshama, to his inner part of him. ועבודתו היא לשם שמיים ממש. אינו מושפע ממקומו ומסביבתו החיצונית כלל. He is not affected by the place where he's situated, from a situation, from everything that's going around him, anything that's external from him. Okay? זה, כאילו, זה באמת רמה מאוד מאוד גבוהה. It's a very high level of, I usually use it in a bad manner, saying wrapped up in yourself, but I'm in it over here in a very positive way, that he's able to really tune in on his energies and listen to himself and to his neshama and really get to the right decision for what's right for him and what's wrong for him. ובאמת לפעול מהמקום הזה. And הרב דסלר says, this is עבודת השם ממש. And then how does it relate to the outer world? Let's see what הרב דסלר says. הרב דסלר says, that avodato il shem shamayim mamash eno mushpa mimekomo mesvivoto achitzonit klal adraba סביבתו יש למקום החשיבות אצלו רק בתור כלי לעבודתו. How does it relate, or what is, how does he use the outside world from anything that is external from him only as בתור כלי לעבודתו, only as tools to serve God. אוקיי? והיינו כביכול, כבחינת הוא מקומו של עולם ואין העולם מקומו. אוקיי? This is the person. I don't know if you're familiar with הרב שאול בר מלך. I don't know if I'm saying it right. I don't have the book right next to me, but he speaks about it a lot. Adam apnim ve'adam achutz, a person that is tuned into himself, and a person that is tuned outwards. Okay, Adam apnim ve'adam achutz. He talks about it a lot, and it's very interesting because Rav Dessler ikdim oto be'arbe shanim, ve'hu medaber bidyuk al oto davar. And Rav Dessler says that I'm going to continue reading in number 3, that a person like this of isha pnim, ish kaze eno zakuk le'etzot mibachutz, a person like this that's tuned in onto him, into inside, inwards, he doesn't need to hear any advice, any wisdom from out of his world. Why? Ki hu motze et kol ha'etzot benafsho. His neshama I don't know how to say it in English. I'll say it in Hebrew and then in English. הוא כל כך נגיש לו. הנשמה הרי היא יודעת את הכל. אז זה כל כך נגיש לו לשמוע את הנשמה שהוא לא צריך להקשיב החוצה. Okay? His נשמה is... how do you say נגיש? Available for him, maybe? Available for him to hear? I don't know if that's a good word, but do you understand what I'm saying? Well, his
available, Nagish is available.
I don't know. Is available a good word for him?
I don't know.
It's to say that all his inner wisdom is he could hear his inner wisdom.
It's like accessible.
Accessible. Yeah, that's a good word. Exactly. Accessible. That's the word. His inner wisdom, his neshama is so accessible for him. He doesn't need to go out there looking for different advice and tips and wisdom and whatever. Akol nagish lo, he's got everything there in it, right in his heart. He's able to hear it all the time. Okay? Ish kaze eno zakuk le'etzot mibachutz, ki hu motze et kol ha'etzot benafsho. כמו שכתוב, לעצה ותושייה, אני בינה, לי גבורה. This is a pasuk from Mishlei. But I want to ask you a question before we continue reading, okay? Let's say we all finish the shiur and we say, okay, we want to be now inwards person, okay? אנחנו רוצות להיות אדם הפנים. מעכשיו, from now on, I'm only listening to what my heart tells me, what my neshama tells me. What is the problem? What is the ma kashe po?
You're not available to other people's wisdom.
Okay, one second, let's put that on the side. What is the problem if I'm going to only listen to what I think that I'm hearing inside? What do we hear inside? Do we only hear our neshama?
No, you hear all kinds of things that are going on in there.
Bidyuk, there are many different voices inside. We have the Yetzer Hara or Sitra Achra inside that we're hearing. So how are we going to know to differentiate between our voices from the Neshama and our voices from the other side, from the Klipot, from the Sitra Achra, from Yetzer Hara? When I see a beautiful ice cream and I hear a voice inside me telling me, forget your diet, eat the ice cream. Forget diabetes, eat the ice cream. Forget that it's not healthy for you and it's chemicals and eat it. How am I going to know to differentiate between the two different voices in myself? נכון? שאלה טובה? זה בעיה, it's a problem. So I tried to look it up. I couldn't find the source, but I am 100% sure that I learned it once in the Ktavim of Rav Kook, and Rav Kook said something very, very interesting. And this is the answer that he gives. And soon we'll see what Rav Dessler says. Rav Kook says, that is why education is so important. Because if we take our children and until they grow up, they only see appropriate TV programs. They only meet personalities or characteristics of people that are spiritually on a high level, okay? If their whole outside world that you I don't know how to say it in English,
expose them to.
Okay, not only expose them to, but also access them to. לתת להם נגישות ל. אם אתה תמלא את הילדים שלך בתורה, במצוות, בדברי חוכמה, מקיף אותם בדמויות מאוד חיוביות מהעולם היהודי, אתה רק ממלא אותם ואתה רק נותן להם נגישות לדברים כאלה, כשהוא יגדל, הוא יוכל לסמוך על הקול הפנימי שלו. I'm going to try to say it in English and I'll probably need your help. Rav Kook says, if you show your children only anything external to them will only be good things, will be things that are connected to Torah, to mitzvot, to, I don't want to say רבנים, כי אני לא חושבת שרבנים הם רק טובים, יש גם הרבה רבנים שהם לא טובים שראינו, אבל לדמויות משמעותיות מבחינה רוחנית. I'm trying to say it in English, but I find myself in Hebrew. I'm sorry.
I think one of the things that you're trying to make is that if you set an example and that you become a role model based on what you think is correct, based on your education, among other things, there's no handbook to raise children. It is...
Halevai.
That you do the best you can with what you got. But I think the point over here is that you try and put, to use the cliche, you put your best foot forward and hope and pray that the results are what you want. But you try with what you've got. Becky, you disagree?
I think if that was the case, you wouldn't have anybody sotemi haderech that comes from a good family.
You do the best that you can with what you know. You can't really look inside every person and determine what a friend of mine did everything that she thought right. And her kids just went off the derech and she couldn't understand why. And they couldn't explain it to her either. It was the wrong fit for them, was what they said.
So that is the makom that we spoke about before. But I think it's, and I'll tell Archiv what you're saying, May, because it's not only doing your best, it's also exposing them. Exposing them to, איך אומרים תוכן?
Contents.
Thank you. It's exposing them to contents of Torah, of mitzvot, of role models that you think that are mat'im. Rav Kook goes so far as saying, don't bring into your house people that you don't want your children to grow up to be like them. I remember my sister told me that she met in camp all kinds of, you know, on the spectrum of religious people. And then they come to Israel and they want to come to her for Shabbat. And she even had a couple of homoim that came to her with their little child. They came to her for Shabbat. And I told her, you know, I mean, it's very, יש פה דוגמה אישית להכנסת אורחים ולקבלה והאכלה, which is beautiful. But what are you showing your children on the other hand? I mean, I don't know what's right and wrong. I just told her, just think about it. Rav Kook says, don't bring into your house people that you don't want your children to grow up to be like them. עד כדי כך הוא אומר.
אבל אי אפשר להשאיר ילד בחממה. הוא הולך לבית ספר, הוא מסתובב בשכונה, הוא מגיע לקניונים. זה בלתי אפשרי שהוא יישאר בתוך החממה.
הוא לא מדבר על להשאיר בתוך החממה, אבל הוא אומר, כל מה שאתה יכול לחשוף אליו, תחשוף אליו לתכנים חיוביים, לתורה, לדמויות רציניות. זה מה שהוא אומר. Okay? טוב, but we're gonna, this is what Rav Kook says. It's just something that I learned a while ago. I couldn't exactly find where it is. I found something small that he says, but if we'll have time, maybe I'll read it at the end, okay? But I want to get on because we are, יש לנו דרך ארוכה פה. טוב, אני חוזרת לרב דסלר במספר 3, אוקיי? דיברנו על איש הפנים, and now we're going to talk about האיש החיצון. אבל החיצוני, a person that is, סליחה?
This is the מלך בר שאול you're talking about, right?
Yeah, but this is, אבל זה במילים של הרב דסלר.
אוקיי.
כל הציטוט פה זה של הרב דסלר ממכתב מאליהו. אוקיי? אבל
האיש החיצוני ואיש הפנים.
אמרתי פשוט שגם הרב אלימלך בר שאול מדבר על זה.
נכון. אוקיי.
אבל אמרתי כמה זה מדהים שהנה גם הרב דסלר מדבר על זה, ו-I think he was many years before him.
He was.
אוקיי. אבל החיצוני, the person that is affected from the external world, המושפע מכל צעד ושל מסביבתו, every little step that he takes, everything is affected by what's going on around him, and he's also affected ממידותיו הרעות מבפנים. Okay, I think he's also saying over here without saying it that a person that only looks outside and then decides for himself what he does, זה מפתח אצלו מידות רעות מבפנים. Okay, it develops bad מידות. הוא אינו יכול לשאוב את עצותיו מפנימיותו. He can't draw any good wisdom from within him. Okay, why? Because זה לקוי, it's missing. Okay? ועצות טובות נמצאות רק במדרגת לפני השם. אבל החיצוני זקוק לעצות כחיי נפש ובלתם הוא אבוד ממש. וחיצוני, the person that makes his decisions and decides what to think and what to feel according to what's going outside in the world, without looking outside, he's lost. He needs it just like he needs water and oxygen for his body. Okay? Bil adam hu avud mamash, he's lost without it. And then Rav Dessler says, ki asitra achra chazak meod meod. Okay, the יצר הרע is very very strong. מאין ניקח החיצוני עצות להתגבר על יצר הרע? So he asks, okay, so we understand that the inner person can look inside because he had good education or whatever, and he can take wisdom, he can draw wisdom from within himself. But what is the other person going to do? The external person, האדם החיצון, how is he going to overcome יצר הרע? ברור שאין לו עצות. Of course he can't tell himself anything. אלה העצות שגילו לנו חזל בחוכמתם. He says, חזל already told us what to do for times when we are looking outside. I just want to say one more little thing before we continue to the עצות. I want to say that maybe at the end of the day, when we look at ourselves, the highest level can be a person that is 100% of his time only looking inside, an internal person, להיות בן אדם פנים בכל רגע ורגע בחיים, and that's a big wow and a very high spiritual level. But I think that maybe it would be more mateim to say that every one of us, there are times when we are more internal, looking inside, inwards, and maybe there are times in our life when we are making a mistake and we are being more external, looking outside and making our decisions according to what's going outside. What people are going to think of me, okay? What are other people doing? I'll do what everyone else is doing, okay? I remember that I used to speak a lot about that with my daughter. With one of my daughters, they had a girl in the class that no one liked. She was a little bit with special needs. And no one liked her. Okay? בחברה שלנו החזק שורד. אין מה לעשות. Whoever is smart and strong and physically is strong out there in the yard and the recess in school, those are the kids that are שיותר מתקבלים בחברה. And what happens to someone who's more chalushes, who's weak? The children don't like them so much. And I told my daughter, we did Sibat Lag BaOmer, we're doing a big meduah, and I told her, I said, invite her over. Everyone else is coming. Her mother called you to ask her to ask you to invite her over. So invite her over. And she says to me, Ima, the girls don't like her. And if I'm going to invite her, they're not going to like me either. You know what they're going to say about me if I invite her? And it was so, it hurt me so much to hear that. I mean, she was little. She was in Kita Gimel or Daled. אבל זה ממש כאב לי ש-this is the way the world goes out there for the little kids. And טוב, of course, I didn't stop talking to her about it. And they ended up coming, and I told her to come with her parents, and then the other kids came. I did a big mishmash, and I don't know really what happened there. I don't remember. אבל זה פוגש אותנו בכל רגע בחיים. We really meet this very often in our life. We'll do... I don't know, I mean, if you think about mishloach manot even, it's also a good example, okay? Are you going to bake something? Are you going to cook something? Are you going to buy something? Are you going to just register for the mishloach manot ha-yeshuvi? What are they going to think if they bring you and they don't give you? Maybe I'll just buy a Purim card. Kol ha-sipur hazeh. In every second of our life, we are really dealing with it, okay? So Rav Dessler doesn't say that, but I want to say that. Okay, so then Rav Dessler, back to Rav Dessler. So how are we going to know how to be, to overcome, to cope with our Yetzer Hara? Okay, so then Rav Dessler brings the Ramchal, okay, Sefer Mesilat Yesharim. ממש התרגשתי לקרוא את זה, because I remember that we spoke about this when we did Rabbi Nachman. So soon I'll remind you of that also, okay? So Rav Dessler says like this, he brings a Ramchal, Rabbi Chaim Lutzato, and this is what he says. וזה כי העצה האמיתית הזאת לא יוכלו לתת אותה ולא לראות אמיתתה, אלא אותם שכבר יצאו מתחת יד יצרם ומשלו בו. Okay, what is the עצה of a Ramchal, how to deal with יצר הרע? To learn from people, okay, to learn from people outside of you, of course, that they were able to overcome Yetzer Hara, okay? שיצאו מתחת יד יצרם ומשלו בו. And they are able to rule themselves, okay? They are able to know how to overcome Yetzer Hara. כי מישהו עדיין חבוש במאסר יצרו, whoever is imprisoned by his Yetzer Hara, אין עיניו רואות האמת הזאת, ואינו יכול להכירה. Whoever is imprisoned by יצר הרע, he is not able to see that he is being ruled by יצר הרע. He is not able to see it. He doesn't even know that he's making a mistake. Okay? כי היצר מסמא את עיניו ממש, because the יצר הרע causes the person to be like a blind person. Okay, mamash blind, or in English, mamish blind. Okay, and now listen to the next sentence that he says, and I hope you'll remember what we learned. Vineu keolech b'choshech. It's like as if he's going in the pitch darkness. Sheyesh lefanav michsholot ve'en enav ro'ot otam. It's like a blind person that's walking in the pitch black. And there are different obstacles in his way, and he can't see them. Okay? And then he can make two different mistakes. One mistake is he can't see where he's stepping, and then he falls into a pit, or he trips over the obstacle. And the second type of a mistake that a blind person like this can make is that he thinks that he sees a person, but he's only seeing...
a pillar.
Okay, וכן להפך, he can see a pillar and think that he's seeing a person, And this, I'm just saying it short already because Arav Ramchal goes on and on over here. And this is the way our, the chomriyut and the gashmiyut of our world blind us people. They blind our minds, okay? And they cause us to make these two different mistakes, okay? Do you remember that that we learned in Sipurei Rabbi Nachman, that was last year or 2 years ago, I don't remember.
Last year.
But Rabbi Nachman tells a story about blind people that are walking in the darkness, in the pitch black. They're walking off into the distance and they're happy and singing and they're very jolly. And Rabbi Nachman says, how can this be? They're blind. They don't know where they're walking. They can't see their next step. How can it be that they're walking in such a confident way? Do you remember that story?
Yeah.
Do you remember what the answer was? At the head of the line is walking a person that he can see.
Right.
And each
blind, they're attached. They're attached to the person who can see.
Everyone, each blind person is holding onto the shoulder of the person before him, and it's like a train. Okay, and at the end of the train, הקטר של הרכבת הוא לא עיוור, הוא פיקח. זה המשל, this is the beautiful משל that Rabbi Nachman brings on this Torah of the Ramchal, okay? That he's explaining how can one person that already was able to overcome Yetzer Hara, how can he help other people out of this place? So that was a small reminder of Rabbi Nachman and that beautiful Torah that we learned. And maybe I'll just say a few more things about that before we continue. That this is the question that we should be asking ourselves. Who is our leader? Who is the person that we can follow that he's already overcome? He governed the Yetzer Hara. Hu yodeach listader ito. Hu kvar itgaber alav. Is it a person that leads us out of the pitch dark? Can it be a certain day of the year? Rabbi Nachman wrote it, he wrote it ביחס גם כן לליל הסדר.
זהו, חשבתי ככה.
כן, that ליל הסדר is one of these nights that can illuminate the light, illuminate the darkness with a lot of light, shine its special lights in ליל הסדר and show us the way out of the pitch darkness. Okay, any other special day during, I think also Purim can be a day like that. Any day that we decide, any special day, any special person that we decide that can show us the way out of the pitch darkness, so be it, says Rabbi Nachman. Okay, זה לא רק בן אדם, זה יכול להיות יום, זה יכול להיות אישיות, זה יכול להיות מצווה, זה יכול להיות תורה. Okay, so that was Rabbi Nachman. From the Ramchal. Okay, so we were talking about Ben Adam Apnim and Ben Adam Achutz, okay? Because I just want to remind you that we started out with Hine Makom Iti, from the word Makom, okay? Haim anachnu mushpaot mea Makom, o sheanachnu mashpiot ala Makom. Are we affected by the Makom, by the place, by the situation, by the external world, or are we affecting the external world and are making our decisions and making our different thoughts and feelings and actions according to what's going on in the world inside me? Okay, so from Makom we got to the Adam Pnimi ve Adam Chitzon, and then Rav Dessler asked, how can we overcome Yetzer Hara if I can't find the answers within me? And then we went to the Ramchal that explained to us that we can be helped by someone that already was able to be mitgaber al yetzer hara. Okay? Kulam itim ba'tiul shelanu po hayom? Okay? Az bo nelech lemispar 5, bo nikra at Rav Dessler ב-5. Rak otam shekvar mashlu beyitzram yecholim liyetz lanu ve'le'arot lanu et ha'derech hanechona. Ve'rak im nishma lahem nuchal latzet min ha'mevucha. Okay? This is these are Rav Dessler's words. Only those who already overcame Yetzer Hara can show us the way out. Okay, and then let's go to number 6. I'm already preparing you that it's a bit difficult, אני, קשה לי קצת לקבל את זה, זה, מה זה קשה לי לקבל את זה? הוא דורש מאיתנו רמה רוחנית מאוד מאוד גבוהה. He's, הרב דסלר is saying, okay, so we know how to overcome our יצר הרע, but how can we become people of leading ourselves from inwards, okay? איך נהפוך לבני אדם של בפנים? איך נהיה אדם הפנים? איך נהיה כאלה אנשים? אז הרב דסלר נותן לנו כאן שלוש עצות, אוקיי? I'm reading in number six. שלוש עצות לחיצוני, שבהן יוכל להתקרב אל הפנימיות. בסדר? אוקיי, number one is like this. יקדם בברכה כל איסורים ששולח לו השם יתברך, כי הם סיוע גדול לשבר את המידות ולהכניע את יצרו, ורק על ידם אפשר להיכנס לשער השם. The first wisdom, the first pearl of wisdom that הרב דסלר is telling us, is יקדם בברכה כל איסורים ששולח לו השם יתברך. You remember before we said, הרב דסלר said, that a person shouldn't complain and be sad about the place in his life or situation in his life. נכון? That's where we started off the שיעור. בן אדם לא יתלונן ולא יהיה בעצבות ויגיד, זה לא פייר, למה אני במקום הזה בחיים שלי? אלא יבין שזה איפה שהשם רוצה אותו. So over here now he's taking it and he's turning it upside down and he's saying, at times in your life when you're being outwards, external, you're being Adam Achutz, if you want to be Adam Apnim, at that moment, be willing to accept whatever Hashem gave you to deal with. And not only to accept, okay, look how, הוא אומר את זה אפילו בצורה קיצונית, he's saying, יקדם בברכה, okay, you'll be willing to accept it in a bracha, you'll be, he doesn't use the word happy, but maybe to value, you should value your Yisurim, and understand that these Yisurim that Hashem is sending to you is in order to make you on a higher level of being Isha Pnim. Okay, when you are willing to accept what Hashem is sending you, when you are willing to value your Yisurim, okay, then it elevates you spiritually to the Madriga of Isha Pnim. This is one etza. מה אתם אומרות על העצה הזאת?
מאוד קשה.
זה קשה לקבל את זה.
בטח זה קשה.
זה קשה מאוד לקבל את זה, נכון? אבל אולי אפשר להגיד, לקדם בברכה אני לא יודעת, אבל כן אפשר אולי בסוף להסכים שזה בא כדי לרומם. זה בא ללמד אותי משהו. ואני צריכה לשאול את עצמי מה זה בא ללמד אותי. ובשום פנים ואופן לא להסתכל על זה כסיבה ותוצאה. אוקיי? ואני אגיד את זה באנגלית, כי זה ממש חשוב שכולם הבינו את זה. I think it's very hard, it's a very high level to look at things at situations of Yisurim in our life and value it and say, wow, אני מקבלת את זה בברכה. But what I think on a little bit lower level that is easier maybe to accept is to say that I can accept the Yisurim. I understand that Hashem wants me to serve him in a better way. I can understand that Hashem wants me to make something good out of what happened. But not to look at what happened and say that it happened in order to make me a better person. We call it in Hebrew Siba v'totza'a. Okay? A cause and the outcome. Is that the right way to say it?
Effect. Cause and effect.
Cause and effect, okay? I think that's a very big mistake to look at it because then you say to yourself...
Punishment.
It's like a punishment and that's a bad road to go down, okay? But it's easier, I think it's for me, it was easier to say, this is Ratzon Hashem and this is the place where I have to work right now. And not as...
I'm sorry. I was going to say, and it's also actually something tangible that you can do. It's like a positive action. It's yeah. Something you can do.
נכון, it's something that you can do. It's when you look at a סיבה ותוצאה, you know, we read a lot about that every day in Kriyat Shema, והיה עם שמוע. right? It says there in a very specific way. It says, if you don't, okay, Rega. I don't want to say it wrong. One second. נכון? ונתתם את ארצכם ביתו, יורה ומלכוש, ואספת את גנך and everything, אוקיי? ישמרו לכם, פנפתי לבבכם, וסרתם, ועבדתם אלוהים אחרים, והשתחוויתם להם, וחרף השם בכם, ועצר את השמיים, ולא יהיה מטר, והאדמה לא תיתן את יבולה. Even over here, we have to understand that it's not a punishment. It's that this is what happens. This is what happens, like putting your hand in a flame, and then you're saying, Hashem punished me, and I got a terrible burn. Okay? It's not a punishment. This is what happened. If you put your hand in the fire, then you get a burn. Okay? So over here, הרב דסלר says, יקדם בברכה את כל היסורים שלו. Okay? כי זה בא לשבר את המידות. It comes to break the madriga where you are right now and to elevate. If you're going to do the right work, if you're going to serve Hashem in the right way, then you're going to elevate yourself to the next madriga.
There's okay? a difference. If I take my hand and I put it into the stove and I burn myself, זה פעולה שאני עשיתי, אז לכן יש תוצאה. But here you're talking about being passive. You get sick. It's not like you did anything. It's like, that's what it is. But you haven't done anything really active to get the...
נכון. That's why don't look at it as סיבה ותוצאה. זה בדיוק מה שאני אומרת. This is, הנה מקום איתי, אומר לנו הרב דסלר. This is your place right now. Be in this place, and from this place, if you're willing to accept your place, right? If you're willing to accept your place and understand that Hashem is here with you, and He wants something from you in this place, okay? משם אפשר לטפס ולעלות. That is, זה המדרגה. That is the מדרגה that from there you can go on higher. Okay, let's read the other two עצות. The second עצה I like very much. השתמש הרבה בציורים חיים הממחישים את דרך הקדושה אל הלב. מחלה ומרפא, כוח הציור. In short, הרב דסלר says, imagine it. Okay, I want you to imagine it. Draw pictures in your imagination of being where you want to be, of being an inner person. Let's say you have a big decision to make. Okay? I use it a lot in coaching. I ask the person, how do you want to make the decision? How do you want to get to the decision? How do you want to look after you made the decision? Do you want to be pondering yourself? Should I have gone like this? Should I have done it like that? Or do you want to be very whole with your decision and just be there? Okay? כלומר, לדמיין לעצמנו איך זה להיות בן אדם הפנים. לרצות להיות שם, לדמיין את זה, לאהוב את זה, להרגיש את זה. ואז אתה תהיה שם. By imagining the good place where you want to be, by thinking about it, by feeling it, okay? By seeing it in your imagination, then you'll be there, says הרב דסלר. I like that very much. It's nice and friendly. And the third עצה that הרב דסלר says, יסתייע בזכות הכלל, היינו שיעשה עצמו נחוץ לכלל, כי אז הזכות הציבור תגן עליו. What does it mean? It means by being a part of your קהילה, a part of the כלל. התכללות, it's called. We spoke about it once. This is a מושג in חסידות, התכללות. Seeing yourself not as an individual as itself, but an individual that is part of the klal, of your whole tzibur. When you're doing things together with everyone else, okay, when you're doing things just like everyone else, then you have a hagana of zchut tzibur. I'm just trying to remember why, I think I forgot it, where you learn it from, of the importance of being part of a tzibur, of the minyan.
That's the minyan.
נכון, זה במניין?
כן, זה חלק מהעניין של המניין.
לא, אבל לא לחרוג מהציבור. למה כל כך חשוב לא לחרוג מהציבור? את זוכרת אותה? פתאום אני לא מצליחה לזכור את זה. אם אני אזכר, אני אכתוב לכם. אני לא מצליחה לזכור את זה, אבל לא משנה. חבל שאני לא זוכרת. הרב דסלר says that if you feel yourself as a part, as a mamash, just like a part of a body, as an organ, just like the organ is part of your body, you feel like an organ of the tzibur that you are shayach to, then there's a lot of zchuyot for the tzibur, okay? And then you have like some kind of a hagana. איך אומרים הגנה באנגלית?
Protection.
Okay, you have the, excuse me?
Defense,
yeah, of the tzibur, okay? And then by being part of the tzibur, of this strong tzibur, and you have defense and you have protection and you are willing yourself to be a part of it, and then slowly, you don't have to do whatever they're doing, but you absorb it and it becomes a part of you, okay? You are them and they are you. Rav Steinsaltz, he writes about it like a fish in the water. The fish is part of the sea and the sea is part of the fish because when the fish is inside the sea, so the water of the sea is constantly going inside his mouth and coming outside of his zimim. I don't know how you say that word in English.
Gills.
Yeah, gills. Nachon. I knew that word. I should have remembered it. So Rav Steinsaltz, Zichrono Livracha, he says, this is the way you should be with Am Yisrael, like the fish in the water. Okay? When you scoop up water from the sea, so then the fish come together with it. The fish are a part of the sea. And when you look at only at the fish, also the sea, the water of the sea is part of him. It fills his whole body. So it's a very nice mashal of how a person is supposed to feel klepei tzibur shelo, kmo dag bayam, shehadag hu chelek mehayam, vehayam hu chelek mehadag.
I was thinking when you was talking about affecting the world, I was thinking about Rav Twersky of the Shalom, and when he gave an address before the Psychiatric Association, he was in full Hasidic garb. And then when he opened his mouth, everybody sat down and was paying attention to what he had to say and what he did. But he had the courage of his conviction to stand up and stand out.
Yefe. Yefe. Very nice. Thank you, May. Tov, so this is the end of Rav Dessler for Parashat Shavua. It's very interesting how he takes one word and, as I said, he takes us on a long trip through Rabbi Nachman and Ramchal and Rashi, and he teaches us this big shiur of Al Adam Apnim and Adam Achitzoni. And I like it the way he doesn't leave us in the air or just with like very far goals of being over there. And he really explains to us how we can get to be people like that, or how in certain situations we can teach ourselves to be isha pnim velo isha chutz. As be'ezrat Hashem, shenizken litkadem od tzad echad be'avodat Hashem. Thank you very much, ladies.
Thank you.
Shavua tov, take care of yourselves.
Shavua tov, thank you.
Shavua tov, bye-bye.